Hey guys, welcome back to another Ableton Live tutorial or breakdown. This is Aldy. I'm so excited to show and share with you this project. This is from my last remake, The Middle, from Zedd, Maren, Morris and Gray. And what I'm going to show you in this video is, first thing, I'm going to break down a couple of key elements of this song. And then I'm going to show you how to make the chords and synths loud enough to sit on the mix, as well as creating an effects chain. And the next thing is how to create a vocoder, because this track also using a vocoder for the main chords in the background. And the next thing is how to create a bus mix for doing mixing in the box inside Ableton Live. And then how to make the vocals sit well in the mix. It's very important. The last thing we're going to see is I'm going to do an A and B comparison with the original. Okay, without further ado, let's start. The most obvious sound you can hear in the track is this. Most people thought it was a clock ticking. Yes, it is a clock ticking, but the very, very beginning is actually the sound of a blinker sound from a car, a turn signal or blinker from car. So in this remake, I use a sound from 2016 Ford Focus. It sounds like this. And this is the original video that I took from YouTube. That's the original. And then I layered it with the fully. In this fully, I use the guitar pick and click sound. It's basically just a guitar pick. It is a celluloid or plastic sound. And then I layered it again with the clock fully. So basically, these two are just one single shot. And what you need to do is just pitch up or pitch down the second part, so we'll create a clicking sound. Like that. And we copy all through the songs and start from this part. The clock ticking is faster than the first one. The next thing, of course, we have the keys. Consists of pianos, organs, and a couple of marimba. Sounds like this. It's very simple. Okay. Not much going on the first. And maybe we can proceed to the hook. This is the interesting part, because this song's also using a vocoder. So I use a vocoder again in this track. It sounds like this. This vocoder basically just the acapella. I put it in the track and I insert a vocoder effects from Live, the built-in effects. And I have three layers of vocoder. It's playing the high pitch, the mid pitch, and the low pitch. Yeah, the difference is only it turned down a couple of semitones in the format. Okay. And then we need to have one synth to trigger the vocoder. these triggers I only use a massive. This is a basic preset. Actually, I only use one oscillator. No need to use the other stuff. What you need to do next is just choose the carrier to external. And then Live will tell you which audio to hear from. And then you simply select the trigger layer or whatever you want to use as a trigger. And yeah, we have the clock ticking going fast. So everything was sent to the delay bus in here. I used the H delay from Waves. So this delay bus or send also being used by a couple of other elements on the track. The next one, maybe not much going on the drop. It's just simply a kick, the bass, and the synth, of course, with the fullies and the fills. Let's check out the drums first. Let me just solo the drums. So just the basic kicks and snares, but one thing that quite interesting is I used sound effects to create this swooshing sound at the very beginning of the snare hit. It sounds like this. Cannot find it everywhere, but then I found it in my my sound effects library, which is I use it for my movie production and post production. So yeah. That's how you do it. And the snare. This is just a basic future bass snare. And the processing's basically just an EQ and a compressor. Two EQs and a compressor. Yes. You can use any of the compressors, it will work. Okay, and the drum group are basically just the cymbals. Crash hats and the 808 kit that you listen in the background sounds like this. Yep, that's it. And then I have the bass. Bass is just a simple sub that I always use from Silith. The second one is the mid bass. Also use silence with the distortion on. Okay. And then we have another keys playing. Oh no, we don't have any keys in here. But we have the chords instead. We're going to make the chords sit well in the mix. At first, I create this track. The chords track, I use the pro plugins like the EQ from Brainworks. I use the mid and side mode, and I have another EQs from Alicia, compressor from Alicia, and saturation. I compress with the sidechaining, and then another EQ and The Last Chain. So I was thinking that it all can be done with the live built-in effects, actually. So instead, I create another chain so that you can use to switch between the Pro and the built-in in case you didn't have any of these plugins. So you can simply switch between the Pro or the built-in. You need to make the other inactive. Okay, so the built-in, all these settings are exactly match with each of these effects. So it will sound the same. And do not get confused with this, because the only thing you need to change basically are in the front of the effect chain, the macro settings that are already set mapped with the specific parameters only. So you do not need to change everything in the back. Yeah. Say so I have the orange color is for the Pro and I have the green one for the built-in. Also, if you turn on the note view or the info view, you will see my notes, my explanation. If you go here, you can see the full explanation for this effect chain. So you can use it, you can save under whatever you want to call it. It will be available at any of your live project. So again, yeah, basically the first one is just a mid-side EQ. Next one is in another EQ just to boost the presence, and we comp it with the compressor. And then this actually following the FF filter settings. So we have the saturation and we have the EQ. Let me go back and show you. Filter Saturn. And then go back here. So we have the saturation over here and we have the tone settings over here. So these two are same with this one. That is why the FET filter Saturn also takes quite a lot of CPU usage, because they have a bunch of modules inside here. Yeah. So to save CPUs and save your money as well, you can just simply use the Ableton Live built-in effects. So I already did this for you. You can use it. Let me go back and close. I also already made the simple macro settings that you can tweak. All these settings are only for the FET filter Saturn module or effects. You can close it if you don't want to get confused. And the next part of the chain is the side chaining, of course. I get the trigger from the kick, the low kick over here. And then this is the last EQ from the chain, following the API 550A plugin that I used in the Pro one. This is a very famous 550A from API. If you understand hardwares, if you know hardwares, 550A is the famous EQ from the 500 series, the 500 lunchbox outboard gear. Okay, so basically just bring back the highs, the presence, and tone down the lows a little bit. So just a simple 3-band EQ. Sounds like this. Let's play the synth, the chords. Let's switch to the Pro. Switch again. shoots back. Okay. Did you hear the difference? No? Good. Because I already set it exactly the same, like this. You can use it, or maybe you can just delete this if you don't have any of these plugins. Okay, so let's get back to the chords track. Use the massive again. The serum, another serum. Strings. I didn't use this. You can just delete it. I have a guitar. This is the live built-in packs. I have the guitar with the amp, distortions, and the last one is I have the silenced, a simple noise. Okay, this is a preset from Massive, preset for chords, and the serum. I use my own preset. It's called Futurama. And also for the highs, same preset from Futurama. Yeah. And the guitar is just slightly in the background. You can see the volume is quite low. Sounds like this. And the support is just a noise. Okay, once again, all together sounds like this. Okay, the point is, you need to cut to low end for any chords or keys. Or it's better to use the mid and side EQs. Like you want everything, certain frequencies to be in the center of the song, to be the center of the mix. So what I did here, simply just cut down the lows from the, let's go back, my mouse getting lag. So for the mid frequencies, yeah, both are tone down the lows and boost the highs. And for the side, I only use one frequencies. Just tone down the lows. Okay, so you have everything, only the highs and presence on separate stereo white. And also, I have another layer in here outside the group, just playing the same chords, but with the different settings. Yeah, this one I created myself as well from scratch. And basically you just need a saw, and you need a second one from sine wave. Then I have the chords bounce, means that I render or I bounce this whole chords into a new track. Yeah. For doing this, I have more dynamic range in the audio signal. So you can see we have plenty of room on top. So I still can boost the volume, the gain, and also, if we double with the original group, it will sound more heavy. Okay, that's all about the chords. And yeah, I have the reverse one. Basically, it's just the same files from the bounce, and I just reverse the files, and you will hear something like this. Yeah. The next one is the guitar group. Just a basic guitar from Ableton Live Packs. I use one EQ and a stereo spread. Oh, sorry, I have this amp simulation effect from Waves plugin, the GTR. I have the GTR strum, the guitar strumming, just to layer with the first one. That's it. That's for the guitar. I have plugs, simple plugs. Created with silent. And I have synth first for the second part. And all these fullies. Yeah, just the clocks, bells, and the turn signal. And I have the fills group, which is contains everything that playing just to fill specific parts. Yeah, something like that. This the first two is the electric piano. Yeah, the first one is just the clean one using contact sound library. Second one is from silence. Zedd is quite use this sounds quite a lot. Yeah, again, I created myself to match exactly like Zedd's sound. And then the growler from samples, dubstep samples. And this is the interesting part again, the shout in the background. So this actually chopped from the original acapella. From the acapella track, and then you simply pitch it up and down, or you can just use the perfect key for the note. Yeah. Moving on to the next one is basically the same, but it's just playing a lower note, I think. Yeah, I transpose down 12, minus 12 semitones. Next, I have the lead vocoder. Again, I have another vocoder in here. Okay, let's see. Yeah, just to fill the tail. And the last one is not just the guitar effect chop from my samples, guitar chunk, guitar glides. That's it. That's all. And the rest are the same. Just keep repeating. Okay, now so I'm going to show you how to use how to create a mix bus for doing a mixing in the box inside Ableton Live. So basically you just need to create another return track in here. I always do in my remix or remake that couple of buses that I created here means that I must send each of these tracks to the specific send in here. By doing this, I have a full control of a bunch of tracks in a single note. In a single track. It's pretty basic actually, but you can make your mix quite easy. That you can just simply mix everything in here. So in my example, that I have a delay, drums, a synth, the music, and the vocals means that I send everything here to the first one, like the drums. I send the snare, kicks, drums, and fullies into the drums, and then all these also being sent to the music bus. You see that I have it. I have this track sent to the music bus. If you cannot move the send on the return track, you need to enable it first. Enable send by right click on the sends and enable send, or you can just enable all sends instead. Then in the mix bus, you can tweak again specifically for the instrumental or the music only without the vocals. So if you solo this track, basically you just playing the instrumental version. So it's better to have this mix bus before go through the master, so you can still have your final tweak for the EQs. And also, speaking of tweaking, like I said earlier in the video, that how to make the vocals sit well in the mix. Okay, the first thing you need to do is create the music bus, like I just did here. And then you create the vocal bus. If you have more than one vocal track, like the backing track, backing vocals, the ambience vocals, or anything else, you send all of that vocals to the vocal bus. And on the music bus, you put an EQ, set only one frequency. So you set at the 1 kHz and then cut around -2 dB, -2 or -1 dB. And with the set of the Q settings is the default. The default is 0.7. By doing this, you create a room for the vocals in the mix. Yeah, that's why you need to send everything, all the elements, into one single bus. Okay, and the next step is on the vocal bus, you reverse the step you did on the music bus. You boost the same frequencies, the same Q. I set a little bit higher the Q. You boost the same frequencies a little bit higher. And by doing this, you can have your vocal can be more clear and more presence in the mix. No matter what happened in the no matter what's going on the mix, you still have your room for the vocals. And also, I have this EQ from FabFilter. I simply use the left and right EQ because I want to make it more a bit wider, so we can just simply set or use the left and right settings like this, so it will sound different. Why don't you just meet me in the middle? I'm losing my mind just a little. I hope you can hear the difference. Yeah. By doing this, you can position your vocals more obvious or more in the background. Get wider in the mix. And the last is, of course, the master bus. Okay, I have a bunch of mastering plugins, but basically just a compressor, an EQ, another saturation, another EQ for doing the mid and side, the limiter, L2, the famous L2 from Waves, and I slightly reverb in the mix on the final master track. Let's hear the A and B comparison with the original. See if you can tell the difference. Okay, first I'm going to play my version with the a cappella, and then I'm going to switch back and forth with the original. Tell the difference? Let me know down in the comments. Okay, so I think that will be all for me. I'm glad to share this project with you. It'll be available on the store, and I also provide stems only for you. If you just want stems, you can download also the stems, and I will provide both links in the video description. So if you have questions, just say it in the comments, or maybe you want to say anything, you can write me an email, and I'll provide my email in the video description as well. So I hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.